Hi there, my name's Grant Oliver from the Oracle Mobile Platform team. Now, any new technology introduces its own concepts and language. So in this video, I'm going to take a quick look at the building blocks and the terminology around the development of intelligent bots. Now, broadly speaking, there are five concepts or terms that I'm going to explain in this video. And those are intents, utterances, entities, artificial intelligence, and conversation flow. So let's start with intents. Let's assume we have a banking bot and the user inputs the phrase, what's my bank balance? Or they might say, how much do I have in my savings account? Or tell me how much cash I have in my current account. The point about a good chatbot is it should be able to understand all of those different ways of essentially asking the same thing, which is checking a bank balance. So regardless of the subtleties of language, grammar, or whether you use colloquialisms or even abbreviations, the chatbot should be able to resolve the input to the same intention or intent. So you can think of an intent as a use case that your bot supports. So my banking bot might support three different intents: checking a balance, transferring money, or tracking spending. Now, given that an intent is a use case or a unit of work the user wants the bot to perform, the collection of intents defines the scope or the understanding of the bot. If I was to now ask, who's going to win the World Series or what stocks to buy, then the bot should hopefully respond in a way that gracefully declares that it doesn't understand or can't deal with that request. Now, a bot doesn't inherently understand anything until you define the intents that you want it to handle. So an intent is any unit of work you want the bot to perform. Now, you might be thinking, how does the bot know about checking balances or transferring money? How does it understand that a particular phrase is associated with intent? And the simple answer is, just like with a person who might be working in the bank, you train them. And in chatbot parlance, you train the bot by giving it example phrases called utterances. And the bot will then use a whole bunch of very clever AI, artificial intelligence, to be able to understand not only the training phrases, but any phrases that it detects as being similar to the supplied utterances. So for check balance, I might train it with sample utterances such as, how much money in checking, or what's my current balance. And ideally you'd train it with about 10 to 15 utterances for each intent. And it's worth emphasizing that bots should still detect phrases which are not part of the utterances. So if the user inputs the phrase, can you give me my savings balance, it will still give a high probability that risk resolves to the check balances intent, even though it's not an exact match to any of the training utterances. Now in the banking example, we found that how much do I have in my savings account, or tell me how much cash I have in my current account, resolves to the same intent. However, whilst the intent is to look up a balance, it's obviously checking the balances in two different accounts. One's a request for savings, the other's for the current account. And this is where we introduce entities. An entity is a variable element of an intent that you want to parameterize so that the user has the option of inputting different values, although it's still resolving to the same intent. So the bot will firstly resolve the intent, then secondly it resolves the entity associated with the intent and assigns it to a variable which you can then use in a REST call or however you retrieve the bank balance. So for check balance intent, I might choose to create an entity called account type, which is identified by one of three possible values: current, savings, and credit card. So when I ask what's my current account balance, the bot will resolve to the check balance intent and it will identify that account type should be set to current. Okay, so in that example, I use an entity which was specific to a particular business domain, such as account type for a bank or pizza size for a food bot. But you might also have some general entities such as date or number or currency, which will be useful in understanding the details of an intent. So on a specific date, you might want to transfer money. So date and currency are all variable elements in the same transfer money intent. But of course, it's important for you to get a handle on those specific values. So by assigning a pre-built entity of date and currency to the transfer money intent, the input phrase, transfer $50 to savings tomorrow, would resolve to the transfer money intent and would assign $50 to the currency entity, and date would be assigned to 2nd of August, assuming today is the 1st of August. Now, I touched on this when discussing utterances, and whilst I'm not going to go into this in any great depth, this is the heart of any chatbot platform. The primary challenge of conversation of UI is understanding natural language input by the user. Now, for anyone who studied this problem, you can't simply expect users to type in the exact phrases or exact matches. A rule-based approach isn't really going to fly. Instead, you need to employ a hefty dose of conversational intelligence where the bot will model training phrases into a neural network and it will try to predict how inputs map to intents. And that will likely be backed up by something called natural language processing, where the AI engine has an understanding of an actual language like English. So using NLP, the chatbot could understand that, for example, cash and money have a relationship within the English language and could be interchangeable. It might also understand that cash and capital may also be related within the same context, even though the word capital has a completely different meaning when used in a different context. And that's the artificial intelligence or the intelligence that a bot platform needs. Now, the final term or feature of chatbots is flow. Now, an interaction with a user and a bot isn't just a series of unrelated separate questions and responses. It's a conversation. And that means there's a flow to the conversation. So ordering a pizza might take you through the size, toppings, side dishes, discount code, delivery details, and payments. Each step in the process is something the bot will be designed to deal with and will handle the interaction depending what step it's in within the whole process. So those are the primary building blocks of chatbots, and you might have picked up a couple of new buzzwords as well. So thank you for watching, and look out for some more videos on building intelligent chatbots with Oracle.